of your interests is the theatre. Tell us about that.
I'm keen on acting. I've done various parts.
Can I stop you? Don't mention the theatre.
Well, it's what I'm interested in.
Well, then soft pedal it, the acting side of it anyway. Dons, most dons, think the theatre's a waste of time.
Music is all right, though, isn't it, sir? They don't frown on that.
No, you should just say what you enjoy.
Mozart?
No. No, everybody likes Mozart. Somebody more off the beaten track. Tippett, say, or Bruckner.
But I don't know them.
May I make a silly suggestion? Why can they not all just tell the truth?
I hesitate to mention this, lest it occasion a sophisticated groan. But it may not have crossed your minds, but one of the dons who interviews you may be a woman. I'm reluctant at this stage in the game to expose you to new ideas, but having taught you all history on a strictly non-gender orientated basis, I just wonder whether it occurs to any of you how dispiriting this can be. Am I embarrassing you?
A bit, miss. It's not our fault, it's just the way it is.
The world is everything that is the case, miss. It's Wittgenstein, miss.
Yes, yes, I know it's Wittgenstein, thank you. Can you for a moment imagine how depressing it is to teach 5 centuries of masculine ineptitude? Oh. Why do you think there are no women historians on TV?
No tits.
Hit that boy! Tits. Hit him!
Sir, you can't, sir!
I'll tell you why. Because history's not such a frolic for women as it is for men. Why should it be? They never get round the conference table. In 1919, for instance, they just arranged the flowers, then gracefully retired. History is a commentary on the various and continuing incapabilities of men. What is history? History is women following behind with the bucket.
Rudge.
Now, how do you define history, Mr. Rudge?
Can I speak freely, miss? Without being hit?
I will protect you.
How do I define history? It's just one fucking thing after another.
I see. And why do you want to come to Christchurch?